Hello there. Welcome to this video. Let's get a general overview on Autodesk Revit 2019 with everything you need to start as a beginner. Leave us comments and suggestions below this video to improve our video guides on all Autodesk products. Autodesk Revit is a professional software used to realize architectural and structural 2D and 3D projects, design houses, buildings, and also basic floor plans. In this video, we will touch on the most important features to start for the first time, but you may need practice and experience to create more complex projects. When Revit opens, its start page shows up, with the Resources panel on the right, used to get updates, news, and information from Autodesk. Several ready templates to use in the center, and everything you need to start with a new or existing project or family on the left. These two are different. The standard project is used to design your whole building with several objects and a general environment, whereas families are single objects used as ready templates to be imported on Revit projects. In order to see how Revit works, let's design a very basic and simple house from a new empty project. Just go to New and then choose an architectural template. The Revit workspace is very simple. On top, you have the menu bar, collecting all the main features and tools. On the left, you have several useful panels describing your project. In the center, you get a big preview on your project in progress. All the drawing tools are collected inside the first tabs of the menu bar. The architectural tab is used to drop basic objects, such as walls, doors, and windows. Under structure, everything regarding basic structures, such as beams, columns, or structural floors for tables and surfaces. With systems, you can realize tubes, conductors, and terminals. You can hover over each button to get additional information and tips on how to use it, and also to find other related tools by clicking on the down arrow and choosing it from the list. As for this beginner tutorial, we will just see and use architectural objects. A very simple house is usually designed from the bottom to the top, dropping a floor, then its walls, doors, and windows, and then covered with a roof. Click on the floor button to start drawing a basic floor. When the tool gets enabled, the Modify tab opens on top, with everything you need to change, apply, or cancel your drawing in progress. Inside the Draw section, use Line, Arc, Supline, to draw your floor by dropping each of its straight or curved sides. Just be sure to close the shape or the floor won't be created when you apply it. Use rectangle, polygon, circle, or ellipse to create a floor with a defined shape by fixing two or three nodes on the workspace. You can get tips on how to use the current tool by waiting with your cursor. If you make any mistake with your current drawing in progress, just use the Escape key to undo. While drawing and editing, Revit shows useful measurements on the current object side, radius, or angle in respect to the horizontal or x-axis direction. You also type length and degrees directly from your keyboard. To check and change the units used, just go to the Manage tab and then go to Project Units. You also have snappings to object endpoints, midpoints, intersections, and also perpendicular or parallel directions and extensions. You can adjust the snap option by going to the Manage tab and then to Snaps. While dropping and editing drawings, Revit stays in edit mode, where your objects are shown as sketches in pink color. Once these are okay, you can apply and render them with Finish Edit mode, or undo all by using Cancel Edit mode. All applied drawings will get filling and volume on the workspace. Remember to save your project by going to File, Save As, and then Project. Revit projects are saved as .rvt files, complete with drawings, options, and customized views inside. Revit also has several tools to edit your objects made. To edit an object, you have to select it first. Just enable the Modify tool under the Modify tab and click on the object to select it. This will be highlighted in blue color and will be ready for your next modification. Use Ctrl and X, Ctrl and C, and Ctrl and V to cut, copy, and paste the object selected. Use the Delete key to remove it. If you make any mistake, use Ctrl and Z to undo your last actions. You have several editing tools under the Modify tab. Use the Move tool to move the object by fixing the starting and the ending point on the workspace. Use the Copy tool to make a quick copy of the object. Use the Rotate tool to rotate the object, fixing the axis and the rotation angle. You can also change the anchor point by clicking and dragging its central node. Use the Mirror tool to create a copy by flipping the object through an axis. With Pick Axis, you flip by using a selected side direction. With Draw Axis, you can define the axis direction by fixing two points. As long as you select an object, these editing tools will act on its entirety, keeping the basic object shape and boundaries. To apply modifications on the object subcomponents, such as edges and vertices, just select the object and then go to Edit Boundary. In this way, you return to the Edit mode and select each object side and node to edit with the tools inside the Modify tab. You can also click and drag these to move, and use the Drawing tool on top to change the overall object shape. To modify multiple objects or subcomponents together, you have to select these first and then edit them. To make multiple selections, just hold down the Ctrl key and select each element, or just click and drag on the workspace to select all the objects within the selection area. To remove any selection, just use the Escape key. Once the floor is made, you can start dropping walls. These are different than floors, since they have their base on the ground plane, or any plane parallel to it, and spread in height according to the value set in the top left corner. To drop walls, just enable the Wall tool and click along the floor contours. The walls will merge automatically where they intersect near the vertices. The drawing aids and the way to manage and edit walls is identical to what we have seen for the floors. By default, you start drawing by watching your project from the top to the bottom in a 2D view called Level 1, as you can see from the tab on top. This view is useful to place the wall's base, but it is not the right one to check height and depth. You can get a 3D preview by clicking on the 3D preview button under the View tab. In this way, you can adjust the height of the walls by clicking and dragging the blue arrows on them. You can change the point of view by using the navigation tools on the right, such as the 3D view cube, or the full navigation wheel. In order to move with pan, zoom in and out with zoom, or 3D rotate with orbit. You can customize the walls by selecting them and using Edit Profile. At this point, you can use drawing tools to add and change the shape of the contours as seen for other objects. On the left, the project browser lists all the 2D and 3D views available that you can open on a tab by double-clicking on them. By default, you have a single 3D view with two kinds of 2D views, the floor plans and the elevations. The elevations allow you to see your project from direct 2D points of view, such as east, west, north, and south, useful to check the object's height and the floor plan levels. Elevations are also present on any floor plan view as small objects indicating where their points of view are placed. You can create custom elevations by opening a floor plan view and then using the Elevation button under the View tab. Place the new elevation object and use the Escape key. Then, click on the square to rotate its direction, and click on the arrow to adjust the view range and depth. Floor plans are 2D views with a fixed height or level from the ground. By default, you start drawing from the floor plan called Level 1, which is the ground level. Floor plans are also used to define objects' height. For example, when dropping a wall while using a Level 1 floor plan, its height spreads from Level 1 to the following Level 2 floor plan. In both elevations and 3D views, floor plans are represented as dashed lines, complete with name and height level from the ground. You can create new floor plans by opening an elevation view and then going to Level inside the Architectural tab. At this point, fix 2 points on the workspace and use the Escape key to apply. To rename the floor plan, just right-click on it from the project browser. After designing walls, you can start adding doors and windows. These lay on the walls directly, so you have to use any elevation view or 3D view. Use the door tool to add doors on the wall. The door base snaps to any floor plan level inside the project. Use the window tool to place windows on the walls where you like most. These tools use ready-made objects called families. You can change the template to use from the Properties panel on the left, and customize the shape of the template by going to Edit Family on top. Check out our video description to get additional Revit templates for your projects. Now let's add the roof. Objects laying on planes, such as floors and roofs, are dropped on a reference plane called Work Plane. By default, this is fixed to the floor plan called Level 1, but this is not the right one for the roof. Inside the Work Plane section, click on Set to choose another floor plan to be taken as reference, and use Show to check where the work plane is set. Once the reference is ready, you can use the drawing tool to create the roof. When the roof is applied, this is completely flat by default, but you can customize its shape by using the tools inside Shape Editing. Use Add Point and Add Split Line to add nodes and lines on the roof. Then use the Escape key and click and drag each of these to move and customize the shape of the roof. Use the Escape key again to apply. If you make the roof by enabling Defines Slope, Revit will define height and depth of the roof automatically without setting any point or line manually. When the roof is made, you can edit its boundaries by using Edit Footprint, and its depth and shape with Modify Subelements, in case you have defined these manually. To undo all the points and lines applied, just use Reset Shape. You can adjust the project preview by using the Visual Styles button at the bottom. For more realistic preview, use the Render button under the View tab. Thanks for watching this video. Don't forget to check out our channel for more and free video guides for other software from Autodesk.